Just like Michelangelo into the blue on heavenly wings. Chicago ham bones don't take off no smoke, no mirror, no strings. I can't take off these dark shades. I can only say how it's too beautiful. Our town on TV, our town. There's you and me, upside down, hanging out of an aeroplane.
Welcome to our town, Memorial Day 2007. We're at Alliance Park, and today we have a whole tour of Amesbury for Memorial Day. So please stay tuned.
this monument, but when we raise the visibility, the recognition of this monument, we do so for our veterans. So I'm going to ask right now, as a token, Bob Alsop and Bob Smith to just unveil the sign right now, please.
gather to honor and pay respect to our comrades who have departed this life, it is fitting that we remember first our great nation. You have given us a rich and beautiful land for our heritage. We humbly pray that we may always prove ourselves a people constantly aware of your favor, and therefore anxious to demonstrate our gratitude and seeking to know and to do your will. Grant that we shall appreciate and treasure the freedom that is our gift and our heritage, and that we may never forget the great price at which it was purchased for us all. May our land be...
Thank you. Sounds like it's working. Commander Bob Smith, Veterans of Foreign Wars, Post 2016. Thank you and welcome today to the Memorial Day services in Amesbury 2007. Today will be a full day of reflection for this country and community. Remember our national flag for the blue field with all stars for one nation, the white for purity of freedom and country, and the red stripe for sacrifices of men and women gave for our freedom. As it has been said, freedom is not free. The cost is high, ultimate sacrifice, wounded for life, body and memory. War is with a veteran forever. I'd like to take this time to say thanks to all veterans who have served, to say thanks to all for the flags and wreaths placed at our graves and memorials in town, and the upkeep of all sites. To say thanks to all who teach our children what freedom means and who veterans are. To teach what freedom means now, today, and tomorrow, hopefully will make for a better future for all. Thank you all for attending today's services, and have a nice day.
Us free and it's an honor to be here wearing two hats, in a sense, that as the elected leader of this community and as a veteran, and proud to serve in both. Thank you.
I'd like to acknowledge a couple of folks that marched in the parade. Tom Iacobucci. Where's Tom? Still here? Introduces Lieutenant Colonel. He's actually Lieutenant Commander. tenancy. if this was actually rehearsed. Father Mark Bishop is currently the co-pastor at Holy Family Parish. Father Mark is a Navy chaplain who recently returned from Iraq, where he served as chaplain to the 1st Battalion, 25th Marine Regiment. The battalion served in Fallujah, one of the most dangerous areas in Iraq. Oddly enough, he was doing his work even in Iraq, because in the May issue of Reader's Digest is a story of his valiant efforts and that of the battalion to provide medical care to the United States for a severely disfigured Iraqi child. Father Mark is mentioned in this article. Please welcome Father Mark Bishop.
They told me I could speak as long as I wanted, as long as it was under 7 minutes. Time me. Mr. Mayor, members of the City Council, friends all, thank you for allowing me, this newcomer, to address you on this solemn day for us as a nation, as a local community, and as a people who have directly benefited from the sacrifice of our brothers and sisters. Please pause with me for a moment to remember those that are dear to us, that have died in defense of our liberty. Their blood is the cost of our freedom. Thank you. For me, who served in Iraq, it is too intimate. The 11 names of the men I held memorials for, the other memorials I attended, and those wounded that I prayed over. I see every one of their faces, and I see every one of their faces in honor, because they have served us so well. It is good that we have gathered here today to remember and honor our fallen brothers and sisters. Our actions today are significant and lasting. It demonstrates that we have not forgotten and will not forget that our liberty is ensured too often by the blood of the young. When I was asked to speak at this event, I asked myself, what can we do to ensure that the sacrifice that we commemorate today remains to be honored? It brought me back to a room at 29 Palms, California, Marine Corps installation, where it is written on the wall, "Let no man's ghost say he was not trained. Let no one who goes in the battle not have what they need for their safety and to bring about the completion of the mission." The best way to honor those who have died for our country is to ensure that those who are currently serving have the means to be ready for battle, that they have their physical, emotional, and spiritual needs addressed. All this at the time in our nation's history when the same amount is spent on our defense is spent on litigation. We honor the dead when we serve the living. I learned this all too well while having the privilege to serve with the Marines and Sailors of 1st Battalion, 25th Marines in Fallujah. You see, the day was September 4th. I was in the middle of performing a memorial for Corporal Pearson. During the memorial, we heard an explosion in the background, not something unusual for that part of the world. The explosion, turns out, took the lives of three those I was serving with, and seriously wounded another: Doc Walsh, Jared Shoemaker, and Eric Valdepenis died that day. And Cody Hill, the driver of the Humvee, was able to make it out and is now recovering in a burn clinic. But you see, that wasn't the story. The story is when we finally got back to our base of operation And I started talking to the men, expecting to deal with the anger and the pain of loss. And I did deal with that. But truly what happened is they recognized the mission at hand and the need to complete a mission that had been begun. Doc Walsh was the one who found little baby Miriam along with his MAP platoon. He took pictures of her showing that she had a birth defect and brought them back to myself and the battalion surgeon, Captain Dunneman. And we started working, reaching out to everyone we could reach out to, discovering what our mission truly was to bring that little girl home. And after the death of Doc Walsh, the mission became further understood to complete his mission and to honor him by completing his mission. So after a lot of cajoling, convincing senior officers, convincing legislators back in the United States, if you read the article, including Senator Kennedy, who was very, very instrumental in his office, Mass General Hospital, bunch of different projects, raising the money. On September 4th, we didn't know if we could get baby Miriam home, get baby Miriam to the United States, and then back home again. But after the hard work of people working across the country, across the international divides that were so strenuous to us, and then with a simple email and a prayer, raising enough money to make it happen. By reaching back to a parish here in the United States and begging a friend, is there anything you can do to bring about this mission? And within 15 minutes, he had raised the money, and we knew that the tickets were on their way so that baby Miriam and her grandparents could travel to the United States, serving the living, to honor the dead, to never forget that we have brothers and sisters in harm's way that are there by choice, most of them. That are there because there are brothers and sisters and family and friends and mothers and fathers back here whose liberty needs to be protected. I pray that the pettiness of everyday life never prevents us from placing our hands above our hearts when the national anthem is played. Our hearts beat to the rhythm of liberty because silent hearts await the rhythm of eternity. Thank you. God bless you. And may God bless our troops, those who have passed, memorialized today, and those serving. And may God bless.
What I'm going to do is I'm going to read some names off, and as it turns out, administration done in 5 minutes is somewhat sketchy. So I'm not sure if I'm announcing a serviceman's name or a family member's name, but if you recognize the name and you got on this list, would you please come up? Thank you. First is James Orlando Jr. Sean McCollum. John's currently serving in country, in Iraq. This seems too ironic, so I'm just going to read both names, Joshua Potts and Justin Potts. Joshua is currently serving in Afghanistan, and Justin is currently serving in Kosovo. Army Specialist Jeff Johnson. I'm not sure about this, but I also have Marine Sergeant Brian Johnson, who's currently serving in Iraq. There's no such thing as one family serving more than another, but you know, sometimes some families seem to go the extra mile. So this particular family, they have one son who's home now, or at least is in country, who served four tours in Iraq. Four. But this is to honor their youngest son, Joseph, who's currently serving in Iraq. Joseph Day, Lance Corporal, United States. those of you who don't know, Adam was wounded in Iraq. He's currently recovering from his wounds. Sergeant Nicholas Ash. Sergeant Jason Nichols. Sergeant Ricky Hannibal. Specialist Scott Burke. PFC Roland Cormier. PFC Stephen Ringett. Sergeant Albert Rochelot. Sergeant First Class Warren Ames. This young man serves us well in the police department as well. He is a fire control specialist, first class, Jason Kukin. Sergeant Nathan Johnston. Staff Sergeant Matt Connor. Captain Mark Aldridge. Station Chief Daniel Gomock.
person to pass on, post 2106. Arthur Basti was a World War II veteran and fought for his country, fought freedom. His relatives, sons, and daughters are here today. Bob Bastine, Donna Bastine, Jacqueline Bastine, and Stephen. Today we honor Arthur with his duty to country, honoring God.
Sure, somebody is in the sidewalk. That's okay.